Hello, hello, hello. So, hi, I'm Pear. I am playing Alan Wake today, and I named the stream Alan Wake Me Up Before You Go Go because I thought it was funny. Alan Wake is a game that I have not seen many people play or talk about or do anything with, pretty much. So, you know, and they're coming out with a second one pretty shortly here, I think. So, you know, I thought I might as well play the very original one. We're gonna see what happens. I'm pretty sure there's multiple chapters to this game, so I might do another stream on this eventually. But let's get cozy. Let's set up and let's play Alan Wake. This is the Xbox 360 version, but it's on the Xbox One. And so it has the press start to play instead of the press A to play, and I find that a bit nostalgic because it brings me back to Xbox 360. So we're gonna go with new game, normal, hard, or nightmare. Yeah, no, I'm all right. I'll just go for. Yeah, I'm not the best of A gamer, is what I was trying to say.
Nightmares exist outside of logic, and there's little fun to be had in explanations. They're antithetical to the poetry of fear. In a horror story, the victim keeps asking why, but there can be no explanation, and there shouldn't be one. The unanswered mystery is what stays with us the longest, and it's what we'll remember in the end. My name is Alan Wake. I'm a writer.
Alan Wake.
I've always had a vivid imagination, but this dream unsettled me. It was wild and dark and weird, even by my standards. So yes, it began with a dream.
A dream.
Following a typical nightmare pattern, I was late, desperately trying to reach my destination, a lighthouse. For some urgent reason, I couldn't remember. I'd been driving too fast down a coastal road to get there.
Oh, Jesus. Oh my God, I hit someone with my car.
Too late.
Luckily, it's just a dream.
He was dead. I was convinced they'd put me in jail and I would never see Alice again.
Alice? Oh, he's gone. The dead body's gone. Okay, perfect.
Suddenly, his body was gone.
Interesting. Episode 1, Nightmare.
I could hardly stand my feet.
Okay. R turns the camera. Reverse your controls for looking up and down? Nah, I'm alright. Alright. Use L to walk. Hold down LB to sprint. Okay. Whoa, I got down, man.
I had to go to the lighthouse. I knew there was something important waiting for me there.
Right. Let's go then. Rain Cove Point Lighthouse Hiking Trail. Let's go. Whoa. Who's that? Oh, is that the hitchhiker?
You'd
Oh, Jesus. Okay. Me, do you, Ryder? Let's skedaddle.
You think you're God? You think you can just make up stuff? Play with people's lives.
Ow.
And
okay.
Kill
I didn't even see that.
Adds to the drama. You're in this story now, and I'll make you suffer.
Haha, you can't reach me. Missing. Is that me? Let me turn around. Let's see. Yeah, pretty closely resembles me. I fell down a flight of stairs. I didn't mean to do that. Press A to jump. Oh, okay.
You missed your deadline.
Oh. Damn. You can dodge enemy attacks. Press LB plus L to dodge. Oh, that's what the low is. I understand.
You can't stop me.
I can't do. Try it again. Dodge the attack. Let's go. Woohoo! Great work. Successful dodges are sometimes highlighted with
a
cinematic.
Was a character from the story I've been working on.
Ah.
How does it feel to die by the hands of your own creation?
Feels great, man. Feels awesome. Alright, let's skedaddle. Oh, the light went out. What's that look like? Oh no, that's not good. Oh, am I a bit tired? I'm too tired to run from the dark tornado storm happening behind me.
This way.
I can drive. Ooh, who are you? Let's go.
Hurry!
I'm coming, man. I'm shifting back and forth, man. Oh, the bridge. Yeah, the bridge collapsed. Who are you?
Clay Stewart, remember?
Oh, it's Clay Stewart. Okay, it all makes sense now. I'm already inside. You don't have to tell me twice.
Oh, no.
Oh, no what? Oh god, he's still outside. He's dead.
No! Damn it, die! No! No! No!
Oh my god. Oh no. Clay Stewart, my best friend.
I was trapped. There was no way out.
Okay. Oh no. TV with eyes.
Die,
oh, there's multiple.
Die.
I'm okay. Tom the poet. What's going on?
The cabin was a death.
Oh my lord!
I had to get out.
All right, let's go. Oh my lord, bless me. Ow, Jesus. How do I leave? Oh, okay, that's how.
Light.
Yeah, but I had to get hurt first. Follow the light. Okay.
You are hurt. You should go into the light. You are only safe there.
Okay, I will go into the safe haven. Focus. Let's focus. Oh, okay. Makes sense.
You must go into the light.
I'm in it, man. Until I'm completely healed.
Well done.
Oh, is that my health bar?
I have something important to tell you. It goes like this. For he did not know that beyond the lake he called home lies a deeper, darker ocean green, where waves are both wilder and more serene. To its ports I've been. To its ports I've been. Do you understand?
No.
No, no.
Follow my light.
I would. He's gonna be rebuilding the staircase. Alright.
I entered your dream to teach you. The darkness is dangerous. It's sleeping now. When it feels you coming, it will wake up. There's no time. I can only show you the most important thing. The hitchhiker has been taken over by the dark presence. You can't hurt him now. The darkness protects him from all harm. Only light can drive the darkness away and make him vulnerable again. Here, take the light.
The light?
Oh, the flashlight.
The flashlight
okay.
Toward him and burn the darkness away.
Press LT to boost.
Get your darkness out of here, man.
You did it. Now the darkness no longer protects him, but it's still inside, controlling him. He can't be saved. He's still a threat. He is still your enemy. Here, take the gun.
Take the gun. I'm gonna murder this man. It says you. How many times do I have to shoot this guy?
Good. You've done well. Remember what I've taught
you. Thank
you. That is all. I will give you back your dream now.
Okay.
In the nightmare,
thanks, man.
A terrible darkness was taking over the world. The lighthouse was the last safe place on Earth.
All right, let's get out.
You made me this way, and now I'm gonna kill you.
Not necessarily. Oh, okay, he fell off. L plus bozo plus fell off. Got him. Reload weapon, yes. Probably a good idea.
This is it, witch!
Where? Oh, my lord! Okay. I did dodge. It's her battery? Oh my god. Know that I had ridden the darkness from him already. I thought I didn't get to it. I ran out of battery. Where's the lighthouse? There it is. Okay. So I have to go this way. Makes sense. Open. Alright. Flare gun? Yes, please. Flare gun ammo. Switch weapons and throwables. Okay. So I'll switch to the flare gun. Sounds good to me. Let's continue.
Just
oh.
Like.
Not for long. Oh my lord. Yeah, I got him. I should probably switch back to my regular gun now. Oh, I jumped. I was so excited about switching to a different weapon. Where? Behind me? Oh, okay, I fell off. I'm dead. Okay. Well, I was trying to look behind me to see where that guy was, because he said die. So, you know. I mean, I did do what he asked me, so.
You did just like.
Get the cool explosion again. Bang. I'm good. Let's go.
Oh, jeez.
I don't believe you. I will run. Oh, my lord. Oh, my god. Okay. I'm kind of out of breath there, man. Coffee thermos. Okay. I gotta go though. I'm going, man. In. Okay. I'm hiding. Are we good? Spiral staircase. Oh, lights out.
He's here. Alan,
oh.
Wake up.
Who are you?
Baby, just another nightmare.
Oh.
Everything's
okay.
Fine. You dozed off.
Right. Anything more than dozed off would be news for everyone.
Cheer up, handsome. We're here.
Love those Xbox 360 graphics. Okay. That was a very interesting nightmare. Here's the town. Fresh seafood on that building. I'll take some. Welcome to Bright Falls. Alright. Thank you.
Let's act like we're on
vacation.
Hello. Go stand next to that old gentleman there. I want a shot of you with the town in the background.
Sure.
Okay.
I'll even give you a title for the shot. A city boy. Moments before he got eaten by a bear.
I'm not gonna get eaten by a bear, Alan.
Hello there.
Cheer up.
You picked a good time to visit our town. Deerfest is just 2 weeks away.
Deerfest.
Deerfest.
Huh? Did you hear that, honey?
I love Deerfest.
You have a lovely wife. If you don't mind me saying, I'm Pat Main, by the way. Nice to meet you.
Yeah, I'm Alan Wake.
Nice to meet you.
I won't pretend I don't recognize a famous writer such as yourself, Mr. Wake. A pleasure. I'm an avid reader myself. I hope this isn't too presumptuous of me, but I'm the night host at the local radio station. Any chance I could get an interview?
Look, Mr. Main, I'm on vacation. In fact, I'd appreciate it if we could keep my being here just between the two of us. I'm sure you understand.
Fair enough. You can trust me to be discreet. Not a hard man to track down if you change your mind, though. I hope you two have a lovely holiday.
We will. Did you get a picture?
Very nice.
Or
I got a couple of really good ones. And I see you made a friend. That's cute.
Right. Yeah?
Hey, my phone. Seller? How's my favorite writer? Are you there yet?
Barry. Yeah. We just got here.
Are the locals giving you
Barry.
Trouble? Just say the word and I'll hop on a plane and come make sure that you're left alone, Al.
No, Barry, we're fine.
Great. Great. Just want to make sure you can relax. So, how is the place? Has it gotten your creative juices flowing?
Barry, we're just settling in.
Okay, Al. I'll call back later to make sure you're doing okay. And you call me if there's a problem, okay? Okay. I'm just looking out for you, buddy. Talk to you later.
I love you too, Barry.
You know he's going to be calling you every 5 minutes.
Barry is Barry. I can always turn off the phone.
What did I tell you?
Barry again, man?
Text message from Barry. He says hi to you, too.
Alan, we're here. Come on, let's get back to the car.
Is this our car? I assume it is. I want to look around a little bit, though. I want to see what this guy's up
Damn
to.
Damn yuppies.
Damn yuppies.
Come on, slowpoke. Right. You get the full service here. I've made all the arrangements. I drive the car. I'll even carry the bags. All you have to do is drag your cute butt into the car and enjoy the ride.
Yeah, sounds like you've got a lazy bastard for a husband.
Yeah, but I got a thing for him. Come on, you lazy bastard. Let's go.
Okay, let's go.
We need to stop at the local diner to get the cabin key from the landlord. A Mr. Carl Stuckey. He's waiting for us.
Carl Stuckey.
I'll go fill her up while you get the key. I'll pick you up here in, say, 15 minutes?
Sure.
Alan, thank you for coming here with me.
I love you too. Go on. I'll promise to behave.
Alan is very direct.
I'd forgotten there were still places like this. Towns
it's
where everybody knew everybody.
It's by cutout,
welcome
dude.
To the O'Dear Diner.
Hi, I was wondering if you could help me. I'm looking for...
Mr. Wake. Alan Wake. Oh, God. I am your biggest fan. I know people say that all the time,
thanks.
But I really am.
I'm glad to hear that.
Rose.
Rose. I'm looking for Mr. Stuckey. Carl Stuckey?
Carl? Of course, Mr. Wake. He must have gone to visit the restroom. He'll be back in a moment. I can't believe it. I've got all of your books. I got the cutout from the bookstore when they took it out of the window.
And you keep it here. Well, okay. Good for you.
Okay.
Try the coffee. Just don't blame me when you fall in love, because it'll break your heart when you have to leave.
Rusty here is no longer human. Nothing but black coffee under a thin layer of skin.
Yeah, that makes
sense. He's an alien! Alan Wake, the sudden stop. Examine.
Right. So much for quiet vacation.
I can't believe it. I'm having a conversation with Alan Wake.
I don't really want to have a conversation with
you. Do me a favor,
yeah.
Sonny! I can really use a tune right now. Coconut, number 6 in the jukebox. I'd do it myself, but both of my legs have gone to sleep. Bad circulation. Yeah.
Are you serious? Coconut again? You disgust me. Call yourself a rocker. Unbelievable. Ha!
Coconut? Let's play coconut.
You put the lime in the coconut, drink them both up.
Just because we're brothers, don't think I won't murder
it
you.
It does
in
that.
Your sleep.
Get stuck. Yeah, you need to give it a good solid whack. Yes, right. That's my favorite tune. Coconut.
Shut your mouth, you demented has been. If I had my hammer, I'd shut it for you. Jeez.
Now that's what I'm talking about. Yes.
This is it.
Okay.
I've died and gone to hell.
Oh, man. What was I doing? Oh, yeah. I was looking around back here. Staff only. Let me in. Come on. I'm Alan Wake, and you're not going to let me into the staff only room? What are you doing, madam?
Don't go.
What's
in
going
there,
on?
Young man. You can hurt yourself in the dark.
I think I can handle it, ma'am. I didn't want to wait. I wanted to find
you
Stucky.
Don't want
to,
die, to
get the
do
key
you?
And get out as soon as possible. The waitress was giving me a headache. Overeaker fans
listen.
Always did.
She's talking over my thoughts, man. I'm gonna pause for a second. I'm gonna turn off the light in my room because there's a bit of a glare on the TV, so I can't exactly see what's going on in certain spots. I think we're good now, though. Yep, all good. Let's continue. Let me in the women's restroom. Thank God it does not. Okay. Knock.
Hello?
Hello?
Mr. Stuckey?
Carl couldn't make it. Unfortunately, he was taken ill. But I have the key for you and instructions on how to get to the lake.
Okay.
I wish you a good stay in my cabin. I'll come by later to check how you've settled in. And to meet your wife.
Okay.
I insist.
How do you...
Thanks.
How do you know I have a wife? Well, I suppose I am Alan Wake. But who are you and why do you have a veil on?
Cauldron Lake is a special place. Very inspiring.
Great. It looks like you just came from a funeral, ma'am.
You got lucky this time, young man. You can hurt yourself in the dark. This really
he said that last time.
And then I must remind Sarah to change the lights at the station. It's been too long already.
I'm leaving. Can I get in?
That sounds better than your singing.
Are you all right?
Oh, I didn't even notice.
Splendid, splendid. Damn hernia. It swells up like a balloon if I lift anything heavier than a spoon. Yeah, splendid, splendid. It's been a long time, Tom. Good to see you.
Hey, you wouldn't happen to have a bottle on you, would you, Tom?
I wish.
My name is not Tom.
The Andersons, they're local musicians. We're waiting for Dr. Hartman to come pick them up. They wandered off from his clinic at the Cauldron Lake Lodge.
Okay. I'll leave him.
Bye, Mr.
Is my ride not here? Oh, my ride's here.
Mission accomplished. The key and the directions.
My hero. I got some flashlights, just in case.
Great.
Hey, Wake!
Who are you?
Mrs. Wake! Your keys!
Carl Stuckey?
That
okay,
was
so that means the keys that we got weren't the real keys. Oh my lord.
Can you believe this?
Who is that lady then?
This would make a wonderful setting for a book.
Oh my
We're
goodness.
Supposed to be on vacation, Alice. I'll figure it out when we get back home. Okay?
Okay. We can talk about this later.
Bad man here on PBF FM.
I didn't want to talk about it. I wanted to bury my head in sand.
Here's another one of my favorites to go with it.
Once upon a time, I was a successful writer, but that was a long time ago. I hadn't been able to write a word in 2 years, not since my last book.
And now the weather. It's gonna be a clear night, so you folks in the big city might want to look up every once in a while, see those stars winking down at you. It gets pretty dark out here, but they'll light your way.
There's the cabin. I wonder if this music is copyright. I hope not. Also, he hasn't written a word in 2 years.
Wow.
Like, he hasn't written a single word for, like,
it's something, all
anything.
Right. Don't worry, honey. I'll get you inside safe and sound before it gets dark. And I've got the flashlight.
I know. I'm okay.
Alice had a phobia. The fear of darkness. I wanted to make sure we were inside with the lights on before sunset.
She's afraid of the dark. I do have a question. If you're afraid of the dark, like, if you close your eyes, do you, like, get scared? I'm just wondering. I don't know. Once again, no. I mean, not once again, because I haven't said it before, but no offense to anybody who has the fear of darkness. I'm just saying. Open the lock.
Come on. Here we go. Let's take a look inside.
It's dark in
Let's
there.
Take a look inside.
We need lights. Can you figure out how to get the
light.
Power on, honey?
Sure thing. I'm on it.
Yeah, I'm on it. I'm sure there's a generator in here somewhere. Examine. What am I examining?
Hello? Anyone here?
Are those footsteps or are those mine? Little kitchen. Nope. Door's locked in my own cabin.
For a moment, the oppressive feel of the nightmare I had seen on the ferry returned.
Whoa.
Damn.
I wonder why it was this room.
I needed to get the power running in the cabin. There had to be a fuse box or a generator somewhere on the island.
Right. I don't know what this picture is telling me.
cabin looked like a time capsule from the 60s, or even earlier.
It's the 4th of July. It's the 4th of July. Happy 4th, everybody. All right. That's actually, the 4th of July is actually, like, kind of coming up in the time that I'm recording this, so. Happy early 4th, I suppose. Oh, we're at the balcony. Wind chimes. Oh, yeah. Okay. What's that? Turn on? Radio?
The best guests have already started to arrive. Just ran into one on the ferry. Famous artist, no less. We'll see if we can rope him into an interview later on. Now, let's go to the phones. Caller, you're on KBFFM.
Hi, Pat. It's Rose.
Why, hello, Rose. What's on your mind?
I know who that famous artist was. It was Alan Wake, wasn't it?
Oh, my Lord.
Well, Rose,
yeah, that's...
I just saw him at the diner. Oh, I am so excited he's here.
I'm sure he's glad to be here, too. Well, folks, I guess the secret's out. This is Pat May on KBFFM.
he really tried his best, man.
Great. So much for keeping a low profile.
There's a dock. I'm alright. I don't need to go out there. I can't believe he already blew the secret that I'm here.
The power cable goes to that shed over there.
Does it? Yeah, it does. Yeah, it does. What's on this? Okay, nothing. That's not the door. There's the door.
An right. Old generator had been connected to the power cable.
Well, let's start it up. Hey. Great. Sounds good.
The lights are on. Good work, honey. I'll freshen up a bit and start settling in.
Okay.
Sounds
I'll look
good.
A bit.
Sure thing. Have fun.
I will.
It was a beautiful place. I told myself I could rest here, sleep here, and forget about my work. I thought we could be happy here.
I thought? So I was incorrect or no? Alright, it's getting a little bit dark out. Let's head on inside. Examine? What am I examining?
The island had once been the site for a love story. Maybe it would be that again.
G plus E plus I G E E plus I.
Alice? Honey?
Alice. Coffee thermos. How many of these are there?
Alan, I'm upstairs. I have a surprise for you.
A surprise? Well, golly gee, let me see if this door is still locked. There's another door here. That one's also locked. Interesting. What could possibly be behind those doors? Whoa.
Hello there.
I'm not the surprise. It's in the study. Go take a look.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
Surprise!
Alice?
It's a typewriter.
What is this?
I guess I have a small confession to make. I thought maybe you could write here that a change of scenery would get you past...
Damn, Alice, you... Everyone
Hey, just hear me out. There's a local doctor, Dr. Hartman. I read a book of his. He has a private clinic here. He specializes in helping artists.
Maybe so now you want to get me committed?
No, it's not like
don't
that.
Don't yell at your
That's
wife.
Not...
Whoa.
Alan?
I don't, just don't. I don't want to hear it. God damn it, Alice.
Don't Push your wife, man.
God damn it!
I knew she wouldn't follow me in the dark. I needed some time alone to think things through.
Alan, man. I don't like Alan Wake.
Damn it.
Alan Wake is not the best guy.
Alice?
Oh, the lights are off. Okay. I've gotta go save her.
Alice!
The cabin had gone dark. All the lights were out.
I mean, there's most likely a ghost in the house.
Alice!
I'm coming, man.
Coming!
Oh my lord, what? Oh jeez, bats.
What
oh
the
god.
Hell?
I'm coming, man. I need to stop getting low and start running. I'm here to help.
Alice? Alice?
Oh god. Did you hear that?
Oh no!
She fell off the balcony. I guess we're diving in. Let's save her, man. Sounds good.
Keep going, Alice. Wake up.
Alice?
What? What happened to my head?
Waking up in the crashed car felt like I had woken from one nightmare and entered another.
I'm in a crashed car?
I couldn't remember how I got there. All I knew was that something terrible had happened to Alice.
She fell off the balcony and died.
The phone was dead. I'd have to find help on foot.
The phone was dead? What is going on? Our bags are still here.
Among Alice's things was a book, The Creator's Dilemma, by a Dr. Emil Hartman. Seeing the book brought back my fight with Alice. I didn't like it, and I didn't like the guy's smug face on the cover either.
Okay. Wire? I should probably not
touch
that.
The gas station was my best bet. They'd have a phone I could use. It looked like a long hike through the forest to get there.
It does look like a long hike to the forest to get there. Okay. Well, I suppose we better head over there. Focus on what? Oh, my car! Well, now I can't leave, I suppose. I should have probably saved my car. But it's fine, I suppose. I'm gonna save my sprint for when I really need it. Because I assume I'm gonna need it eventually.
Hello?
Oh my god, that's bright.
Hello? Is someone there?
Just papers flying around.
The loose sheets of paper were pages from a manuscript entitled Departure.
Departure.
That was the name I planned to use for the next novel I had never gotten started. I was named the author. I hadn't written it. I couldn't remember writing it. In the scene on the page, the hero was attacked by an axe murderer in the woods at night.
Oh. Oh no. You found the manuscript pages. You can access them with the back button. The back button, which is now the two square button on the Xbox controller. The title page of the manuscript. That makes sense. Wake attacked by a shadowy murderer.
His face was covered in shadows. It was hard to make him out in the darkness of the forest that surrounded us, but the axe he lifted was plain to see. It glistened with the blood of his victim. He grinned madly. The shadows were alive, distorting his features. It was a scene from a nightmare, but I was awake.
Oh no. I hope the game audio is high enough for the pages to be read and heard. Wake fights a taken with light.
It was impossible to focus on it, as if it stood in a blind spot caused by a brain tumor and eye disease. It was bleeding shadows like ink underwater, like a cloud of blood from a shark bite. I was terrified. I squeezed the flashlight like my life depended on it, willing it to stop coming.
I don't have a flashlight.
Suddenly something gave, and the light seemed to shine brighter.
I do not have a flashlight. Episode 1, Nightmare Manuscript. Okay, let's go. Gas station. So am I gonna be attacked by an axe murderer at night?
Anybody there? Please, I've been in an accident.
Please, ghost, I've been in an accident. Help me out. Checkpoint reached. Okay.
The lights up ahead were a good sign.
Focus.
Maybe I wouldn't have to hike all the way down to the gas station to find a phone.
Hey, that sounds good. Let's get in there. Ooh, I've got a... caution. Employees must wear protective eyewear at all times. I'm not an employee, so I'm not gonna do that.
Anybody there? Please, I've been in an accident.
Hey. Please.
Hey, you!
Phil!
There's been an accident. I need help.
Deposit.
Listen, I need to...
premium cabins for rent in...
Oh, hell.
Oh, no.
Carl Stuckey.
Please.
Carl Stuckey.
Non-refundable reservation deposit required. Fair and square. And square.
Fair and square. Should I run from Carl's ducky? I don't know where he is. Like a manuscript page? Fair and square.
The taking stood before me. It was impossible.
Okay. I got that page before I was supposed to. I understand now. So am I gonna have a flashlight soon?
Any second now, and Stucky would be knocking on the door with his axe like Nicholson in The Shining.
Like Nicholson in The Shining, that's what I said. Oh, perfect. Gun, flashlight, like we practiced. Sounds good. Is there anything in here? Batteries? Yes, please. And they're energizer.
During your recommend, trying...
use the phone.
It's the latest thing.
Yes.
It works.
Hello? Hello?
Oh no. Okay.
The spirit.
Okay. Hey, I should probably get out of here, huh? The door's open, let's go. Oh my god. Oh my lord. Okay. Let's get out of here. Should I run? I should probably run. Oh no. Got him. Oh, there's another. There's more than one. Battery, please.
My head pounded.
Revolver ammo? Yes, please.
I'd never fired a gun outside a shooting range. And now I just killed someone. Or something.
Killed two
people.
There
were no bodies. They just disappeared. If I was dreaming, it felt real enough to make me sick.
Let's turn whatever this is on. Oh! Flashlight. Okay. This way. I don't know why I'm listening to the arrows, but
Eerie hand-painted graffiti was revealed by my flashlight. Someone had hidden a chest of supplies near it.
Oh, nice. Flare gun. No ammo? Okay, no ammo. Only one flare. Oh my god, I didn't touch that, man. I was just about to say that I should probably not touch that, and then I did. Kick. Good kick. Strong kick.
The Dark Forest was the last place I wanted to go, but I had no choice. I had to get to the gas station.
I have to get to the gas station.
It's rabbit season.
Duck season. It's duck season. Box of supplies. Revolver ammo. Batteries. Sounds good. I have 7 batteries. Should avoid that. Whoa. That's there, that lady again. Hey, I don't like that one bit.
What the hell was that?
I have the same question.
When I saw the river below, something uncoiled itself inside my head. I realized that I'd have to find a way across. I didn't even want to look at the water.
I found a way across. Oh, there's another. Okay. I have to find another way across. Right? Yeah. Okay, let's go around this way. Huh? I don't think I was supposed to shine that flashlight.
Stucky was still out there, in the dark, stalking me.
Perfect. And this isn't part of this isn't part of the nightmare still? Or was the other part also part of the nightmare? Lithium batteries. Ooh. Picked up item limit reached. Okay, well, I suppose I won't pick those up then. Did I go that way or this way? Where's the gas station? Let me look over here. No, okay. I can't even go this way. Oh, my lord. Hey! This is a perfect time for a flare. I think. Right? Did I use it right? Are they both gone? I think they are. Goshen, proceed at your own risk. Logging area ahead. These logs are gonna fall on me. This way. This way. Up? Okay. I'll do what the flashlight says. Up here this way? Yeah.
Taken. They're taken.
The taken are filled with darkness. Okay? And that's the taken from my story. Oh, there's the fire symbol. Okay, well, I thought I didn't have enough. item inventory space. You lied to me. Okay. I don't like the breathing in the background. Am I supposed to still be here? Walking area. Because I got the thing. Is it leading me anywhere else or no? I don't think it is. I think it's just for that. Okay. Let's head back down then. Not that way. Where was the ladder at? Here it is.
The staircase was broken. I had to make my way up some other way.
I can climb it. Checkpoint. Batteries. Item limit reached. Again. Okay. For both. So I can only have 42 bullets and 20 battery. I think. Examine.
There was no power. There was bound to be a generator somewhere at the logging site.
I see a flashing thing over there. I think it may be the generator. Don't do that. Oh, there's multiple. There's three. I should have saved my flare. Battery. Battery. I should have saved my flare for that moment. Man, I'm a master at starting generators. Okay. That's hard hat area. Should I go in there? Checkpoint. I'm gonna head on in. Manuscript page. Alright. Let's look. I missed a page. Oh man, I missed a page. Okay. Find this page. Oh, okay. Never mind. I did not miss a page. Find this page in nightmare difficulty mode.
I saw them, swooping down from the sky and screeching as they came. I spun around just as the cloud was upon me. For an instant, I stared into 100 dead eyes. Black pearls glittering in the darkness. I raised the flashlight and the swarm exploded like fireworks. Feathers burned, turned into ash. I couldn't hear my scream above theirs.
Oh. That sounds like a great time. Birds or bats? Shotgun? Oh my god, I have a shotgun. Okay. Should I mean, I'll save it. I'm sure I'm gonna need a shotgun eventually for something big. But for birds, I don't know about that. Move log lift. There we go. I was moving it the wrong way. It's a lift made of logs that does not seem very sturdy. Okay. Let's hop on. Or not.
Let's not hop on. Let's bring it down a bit more. Oh, do I have to bring it here? That would make sense. Yeah, I just gotta get on. Pause for a second. All right. We are back. We're getting on this log lift. Is it just going up by itself or no? Do I have to do something? Oh, was I just supposed to get across? Ow. Am I supposed to make that jump? Yeah, I suppose I am. All right. I'll try. Do I have to get a run up? Maybe I have to get a run up. Let's get a run up. There we go. That is what I'm talking about. Checkpoint. I'm safe in the light. Radio? Shotgun ammo. I'm gonna need the shotgun. Eventually.
Well, I was just outside for a breath of fresh air, and what a night. I know most of you are probably in your beds by now, but if you're still up and around, take a moment. Step outside for a spell and breathe in deep. The weather is absolutely still. The sky is crystal clear. It's like the forest is quietly breathing along with you. You listeners know I'm a night owl, and it's on nights like this I wish I wasn't cooped up in the studio. Makes an old man like me wish I could just roam wild. But here I am, and who'd keep you company all night long if I weren't? It looks like I'm not the only one staying up late. Caller, you're on the air.
Hey, Pat, it's Maurice Horton.
Hello, Maurice. What are you up to?
Maurice?
Well, I was just taking Toby on his walkies.
Oh, isn't it beautiful out there? Probably a rabbit.
Sure. Toby loves rabbits.
Well, sure.
Anyway, I figured that, you know, if anyone runs into Toby, they could grab him. My number's on his collar.
And Toby's a friendly dog?
Toby loves people.
I hope I meet Toby.
Usually he comes back, but we were pretty far from home, and it sounds like he went pretty wild there. Great dog, but he's just too dumb for his own good.
Well, Maurice, it's out there now. Hope Toby comes home soon.
Yeah, thanks.
You have a good night now.
Okay, well, I really hope I meet Toby. But I really hope he's not made of darkness. I hope I meet Toby and he's a friendly dog and I don't have to shotgun him, alright? I really hope. But I bet this page is gonna be like, a rabid dog, I pulled out my shotgun. Let's go. Wake finds pages.
At first I kept finding the pages as if by accident. The book I couldn't remember was either a terrible and true prophecy or an act of creation that had rewritten the world. I began to hunt the pages feverishly, for they held the answer to the mystery. With it, I could save myself. With it, I could save Alice.
Okay, I was wrong.
The gas station was closer now. Its light welcoming
right there.
The darkness.
I just need to...
The best dogs in the street. Belly Burster is the best with no curbs. Monster Dog is second best. The famous dog is...
I don't know where you are, man. I'm just trying to get to the gas station. It's a little breezy this afternoon. Hey. Oh my god! I didn't know he threw his axe! Jesus Christ! I got absolutely smacked by a flying axe. Oh good, the light. Carl Stuckey. Axe throwing master. Who would have guessed? Man, I can't see that. Oh my god! I shot him, but I was not supposed to. Oh my god! I didn't even notice there were two, dude. Stop. Stop. I only saw one. In that instance, alright? I need to get out of this darkness storm as fast as possible. Ah! It's our battery. Thanks for letting me know they were there before bombarding me with two again. Let's get out of here, man. I'm running. There's a page. Oh! My lord! I tried to dodge it, but it did not let me. I found a manuscript page. TV in the gas station.
I stepped into the gas station's garage. It was dark and quiet. The place was a mess. It looked like someone trashed the place or that there'd been some kind of fight. Light spilled into the room through an open door at the back, and I made my way toward it. Without any warning, I was blinded by a bright light. An old portable TV on the shelf had come alive by itself. Impossibly, I could see myself on the screen. Talking like a madman.
Interesting. Don't make me find another Carl Stuckey or two before we get there, please. I need this light. Okay, we're all healed up. Everything's great. Maybe I should have used my shotgun. Well, I'm going this way. Maybe I'll take it a little bit slower so that I can see the Carl Stuckey's coming. Well, this says to go this way. Okay, well, I'll follow it. I'll follow it. It'll lead me to supplies, so. Yeah, okay. Here we are. Flare gun. Perfect. Reload. Am I going this way or am I going the other way? I think I'm going the other way. Yeah.
Thank you.
I saw birds, so I got scared because it told me about the birds earlier. Proceed at your own risk. Okay, I will. Whatever was rustling, I'm not gonna look at it, I don't think. If it's Carl, I'll get hit with an axe. It's three Carls. Oh yeah? Well, don't worry, because I've got... Didn't see that coming, did you? Manuscript page. Man, we're really getting far ahead in the manuscript story, but I'm not there yet in real life. Wake lies to the sheriff.
Cauldron Lake?
What?
She asked. The sheriff looked at me suspiciously. The early morning light flooded through the office windows. I would probably never have gotten out of the woods alive without her help. But I couldn't tell her the truth of what I'd faced the previous night. She'd think I was lying or crazy. She'd lock me up, and she wouldn't help me find Alice.
Darn. Well, there's no sheriff from what I can tell around here. At least not right now. Alright. Don't like that swinging thing. Let's go in here. It seems like there's a light on. Alright. Shotgun ammo. Wherever it is, yes please. Maybe I'll just hold that on me for now. I do want to actually use it at least once. Shotgun? I have one. I have a shotgun. I don't need yours. Use. Yeah, okay. I don't know what I did, but sounds good. Use.
Science.
Is this me on the TV?
It bestows immortality on those who advance it to elevate all of mankind. Newton, Einstein, Sagan, princes among men. But the price for such a legacy is steep indeed. In night's
is this me?
Tonight's
no,
episode,
it couldn't be.
A quantum suicide.
Oh.
If our lives are already written, it would take a courageous man to change the script.
No.
Having called a press conference, Dr. Barclay Colvin is about to demonstrate that very courage.
Ladies and gentlemen of the press, I am Dr. Barclay Colvin, and I'm glad so
isn't
many
isn't Dr. Barclay the guy on the
here at the Moorcock Institute?
Book?
Tonight, I'm going to give a practical demonstration of the many worlds interpretation. As you
I
can
don't
see, this
want to watch
is
this.
9mm pistol. It shall be
okay.
Part of a
you got me
experiment. And now, a real experiment, known as a quantum suicide.
Did he say suicide? Is that a real gun? He's kidding, right?
Please, stay calm. There is no risk. Observe what occurs when I place the weapon against my own forehead. Now, you might think this round is merely a dud. Not so. Observe the flower pot. And yet,
oh my God.
I myself cannot be harmed with this gun. With each pull of the trigger, two new realities branch off. One in which the weapon didn't fire, and one where it did. With my machine here, I have ensured that this reality is always the former. I have bestowed upon myself quantum immortality. Under no circumstances can this gun kill me.
So wait. What you're saying is that every time you pull the trigger, in another reality, you die?
Yes, of course, but that's completely trivial. There's an infinite number of things that could happen at any moment, and they always do happen somewhere. The point is, this one thing did not
unplug the cord
happen here.
You're insane, Colvin.
Insane? Insane?
Hey, was this thing supposed to be plugged in? I stumbled on it.
You fools. Gaze upon.
Oh no, God, he's dead. He's absolutely dead. Let me cover my face. Okay, we're fine. Yeah.
Poor, poor Dr. Colvin. Filled by his own hubris or the ignorance of the masses. Perhaps he should have left the crate unopened. The decaying atom unobserved. In Night Springs.
You know, that was very interesting. I don't know about all that. Don't try that at home. Don't do that. It would not be a good idea for you. I could probably shoot those birds, but I don't know. If you ever have suicidal thoughts, go talk to someone. Don't do that, all right? And even if you're not having a good time in life, you know, just think about all the good things that happen or could be happening or will happen in the future. Your friends, your family. Like, look outside, you know, see how beautiful it is, like, how beautiful the place is. If there's nice flowers, you can start a garden, you know. There's a bunch of other options, right? Okay, let's go back to playing Scary Game. I don't want to stand under these things because I feel like they're gonna fall down and murder me. Oh, there he is. Okay. Carl.
Oh no.
Open whistle. The engine.
Oh my God. Oh my God. Oh my Lord. Oh my God. I should have shot the shotgun. That was a bad idea. Oh my God. Oh my God. This is going terribly. Can he not be flashlighted? Oh God, stop. I'm trying to. Oh, Jesus. Okay, I'm dead. Oh no. Carl Stuckey boss fight. Let's try again. Well, okay. Let me try. Let me see. If I stand out of this, I think we're good. There's just a box of stuff here, so. Thank you. I got him. There was another one, was there not? Whoa. Oh my god. Is that stuck? Is that Mr. Stuck? I think it might be. Where are you at? Where are you at? Come at me. He's running circles around me. Oh, I can. Can I? Can I? Is that a thing? Yeah, okay. Doesn't seem like flashlight's working anymore. I'm shooting Carl Stucky. Got him.
Stucky's body vanished, leaving behind only a lifetime of nightmares to come. Assuming I'd reach the lights at the gas station alive.
I got him. I got him. There they are. Please save my game. Okay, I was gonna, yeah. Checkpoint reached. Thank goodness, man. Look at that deer.
I recognize the deer fest float I had seen in Bright Falls when I first arrived with Alice.
I did not. I did not recognize that. Gasoline. I need to pause for a second. I will be right back. Hello. Hello. Okay. I'm back. I had to do something real quick. Let's get into this gas station.
After the insanity I just experienced in the darkness, the lights of the gas station felt comforting. At least for a moment, the sane world reasserted itself.
Thank goodness. 68th Annual Deer Fest.
The Deer Fest had been 2 weeks away when we arrived. If the day count on the banner was right, I was missing a whole week between the night we got here and now.
Wow. A whole week gone from my memory. Breaker's Farm apples. Pick your own apples. How you like them apples? Am I focusing on something other than this sign, or is it this sign? Okay. Closed. Puma Racing oils. Yeah. Let me in, please.
I had to get inside. I have to go through the garage. Find a phone to call for help. The garage was a mess. It looked like someone had trashed the place, or that there'd been some kind of fight.
Hey, I said that. In the manuscript. I think I said those exact words.
I'll keep writing. Outside, there's only darkness. Outside the cabin, outside the story, there's only darkness. I can feel her presence in the dark. Just now, I could smell her perfume in the room. I'll reach her. I'll fix it up. I'll bring her back. The story will come true. If I stop, she's lost.
I don't believe this.
It'd been me on the TV, talking crazy.
Wow.
Was I losing my mind?
Was I losing my mind? I mean, maybe. I assume that happened in the week that I lost. Oh, hey. Hey, Landon is Forever Blue. What's good? Yeah, it's my first playthrough of the game. I'm on the Xbox 360 version. Because the second one is going to come out anytime now. Yeah, I haven't seen a lot of people play this game before. Special offer with coupon. Welcome. Nordic walking. Oh. The game is great so far. Yeah, it's good. It's got me captivated. You're on the fourth episode? Nice. The 68th annual Deer Fest, September 15th to 18th. Games and activities, raffle tickets, fishing competition, pie contest, and surprise competitions, live music. For the children, Bucktoothed Charlie afternoons and Montgomery the Mystic's amazing Phantasmagoria evenings. Don't miss the legendary Deerfest Parade. For a 13-year-old game, it's really good, presentation-wise. Love it. Yeah, it looks really nice. They sell propane. Is there a phone? Yep. My only criticism is by episode 3, the gameplay and enemies get repetitive. I see. That's unfortunate.
Great Ball Sheriff Station.
Oh, it's the sheriff? Oh yeah, I have to lie to her.
Thank God, Sheriff.
Sheriff Sarah Breaker, you are...
I'm Alan Wake, but listen, I was in a car crash. My wife, Alice, she's missing.
Calm down, Mr. Wake.
We were staying in a cabin on the island, on Cauldron Lake.
There's no island on Cauldron Lake, not since the big eruption in the 70s.
Please,
there's
I can
no
take
island?
You there, okay?
You look like you've taken a pretty bad knock to the head. Are you okay?
Listen...
We'll figure this out. Please get in the car. We'll swing by the lake, and then we'll go to the station. Okay?
Sounds
Mr. Wake,
good.
Have you seen Stucky, the guy who owns this place?
I murdered Stucky earlier.
What had happened in the forest. She wouldn't have believed me. And then she wouldn't have helped me with Alice.
There is no lake. I mean, there is no island in the lake. Oh my my goodness. Alan Wake. Exploring during the chill moments in the game. There's some really good world details. For a linear game, it definitely makes you want to explore. Yeah, it does. End of episode 1. Alright. That was good. That was a good time. I'm very confused, but I'm captivated by it. I like the mystery. And it does make you want to explore. Very nice.
Then I fall asleep to dream. My
I've been streaming for 86 minutes, so I think I'm gonna continue, actually.
Previously on Alan Wake.
Yeah. Let's go. I came to Bright Falls is my best achievement.
Thank you for coming here with me. I thought maybe you could write here.
I don't want to hear it. God damn it, Alice.
Now, she's missing.
Alice? Alice?
I woke up behind the wheel of a crashed car. I'm missing a week. I was attacked by shadowy men straight from a nightmare. The sheriff took me to the lake Alice and I had stayed at. But the cabin had disappeared.
Episode 2, Taken. Honey, I'm home.
Honey, I'm home.
Back here, Steve.
Hey.
How was it?
Worst weather I've ever seen.
You should put some coffee on. It'll warm you up.
Hey, handsome. This is going to be a long
night,
but these shots are turning out great.
I guess you're going to need that coffee then. I'll go put it on.
Let me just take her coffee thermos. Okay. I need the coffee. I assume this is a flashback. Coffee. There we go.
Coffee's on.
Great. Thanks. I'll need it if I'm gonna finish this by tomorrow.
Episode 2 is your favorite? Yeah. Well, we'll see if it's mine also.
Oh, hey, I just finished those cover mock-ups. They're on your desk. Tell me what you think.
No kidding.
Okay.
I didn't think you'd get them done this quickly.
On occasion, I can perform all sorts of miracles, my dear.
Oh, really?
Wow.
Well, you seemed to think so last night.
Whoa. Okay.
These look really good.
Oh, look at that.
Oh, sure, until Barry gets his hands on them. Which, by the way, will happen over my dead body. The last time was the last time. Oh, and speaking of Barry, he called.
Oh,
Alan?
Hey, let me pick up this manuscript page.
Please check the
hey, I'll come and
box.
Save you.
I'm right here. I'm on it, honey.
Please hurry.
There's the fuse box. I'm hurrying. Let me just read a manuscript page real quick, all right, wife?
Fall and the sudden stop at the end. I'd lain here in the snow while the lurid chain of scenes that had led me here kept playing in my head. A rerun of my own private snuff movie. A memory of my corpse. Alone at my own wake. Thinking in metaphors again. The femme fatale was gone. Only a sour taste remained of the kiss that killed me.
Okay. The sudden stop.
This was a late goodbye. 13 years after I'd gotten my revenge, it had finally caught up with me. It had been a long time to bear the pain. My blood painted the snow red. A gruesome slushy dissolved all the scattered painkillers and leisurely dripped down to the sewer, mingling with the bile of the city, becoming one with it. I can see them now, my wife and my baby. Honey, I'm home.
Oh no. That does not sound good. Oh yeah, I was doing this.
Honey, it's a power outage. I've got the flashlight.
Okay. Hi.
Don't worry.
You okay?
I'll shine it in
your
eyes.
It just really spooked me.
Don't worry. We'll
hey,
just break
sense.
Out the candles.
Yeah, let's break out the
stupid,
candles.
But it's just... Especially when I'm not prepared for it, you know? It gets to me.
I love you.
No, I understand.
Tell me a story, Ryder.
Okay. I used to have these nightmares when I was a kid. The dark really spooked me, too. When it got really bad, my mom gave me this old light switch. She called it the clicker.
The clicker, huh?
Yeah.
I ever got scared of the dark, I could just flip the switch and a magic light would scare the monsters away.
Oh, sure.
Wow.
Here it is.
Alan.
Maybe it'll help you too.
Yeah, nice story, writer boy. You made that up right now, didn't you?
No. Seriously.
I love you, even if you are a liar. Thanks for this.
That was supposed to be a wahoo, but it ended up not coming out that way, so wahoo! Hey, well, I'm glad they have,
Mr. Wake?
They have
any
character
nausea,
development together,
disorientation,
you know?
Anything like that? Mr. Wake, how are you feeling?
I'm feeling terrible, man.
I'm okay. My head's fine. I had to lie about my headache and memory loss. He'd send me to a hospital for tests. I couldn't leave without Alice.
Very well. I don't think you have a concussion, but you've obviously been through quite a shock. You should take it easy for a couple of days.
Thanks.
Well then, Mr. Wake,
who
we're
are
done
you?
Here. If the pain gets any worse or you experience any other symptoms, you should come see me. I'll let you get on with it then. Sarah, Sheriff Breaker, is waiting for you. She's very good at her job. I'm sure she can locate your wife in no time.
Doc Nelson was the image of a small-town doctor. Sheriff Breaker had called him to the station to take a look at the cut in my head.
I see. Doc Nelson. Oh, he's a fisherman.
I'm sorry you had to cut your morning fishing short for this, Doc.
Oh, she's a beauty, ain't she? Not the biggest I ever caught, if you can believe that coming from an old fisherman like me, but she's right up there. Now, she's a largemouth bass, which is what you're after if you prefer a lure. Now, if you want either trout or salmon, on the other hand, then it's fly fishing for you. You
fly
a fishing,
fishing
man, Mr. Wake? Oh, doesn't
no,
really
no.
matter, I suppose. But it can be very relaxing out there. You can't get me off the water this time of year. Closest thing to heaven.
I'll take your word for it, Doc.
Yeah, I mean, I'll take your word for it. I
believe you'll find the sheriff in her office. Just go down the corridor.
All right, thanks for letting me know. I think I've been fishing once, but it was when I was very, very small. Is that lady from the place?
Thank you for testing the lights, Miss Weaver. Everything seems to be fine.
I don't have the luxury of being complacent, Deputy Grant.
Yeah, it is.
The bulbs will need changing soon. You can't change them in the dark.
I'll be sure to take care of it, Miss Weaver. Have a nice day now.
Very good. I'll come back later on to remind you, just in case.
Have a nice day now, Mrs. Weaver. You can leave.
The sheriff is waiting for you in her office down the corridor.
Okay.
That was Cynthia Weaver. I guess you can call her the town eccentric. She used to be the editor of the local newspaper, but she's focused on, other things these days.
She'd fit right in where I come from.
As you can see, she's a little obsessed with maintaining the light bulbs of the whole town, refuses to step on shadows, things like that. Back in her day, she wrote about all sorts of weird things in the paper. Bright Falls has a colorful history. Of course, what small town hasn't?
Okay. Thanks for letting me know. Is it this way? Coffee thermos. All right. Oh, is that Paige? Yeah. Oh, I actually missed too. Oh no.
Alice looked through the viewfinder, lining up the shot. Cauldron Lake was breathtaking. Something caught her eye. A figure standing in the shadows behind the cabin. Like a thin woman in a black dress. She lowered the camera and looked again. No one there. Just a collection of bushes that looked vaguely human-shaped. She shook her head and laughed.
I don't have two of the pages. How did I miss them already? Is this one? No. I don't know how I... How?
Mr. Wake.
How would I have missed two already? Okay, well, I don't know. Missing poster. for somebody who I can't tell who it is. How about this door? No. Meeting room. Here's the corridor. Read. Read all of them. Have you seen this man? Disappeared on 6/20/07. Identifying features. He has a knack for winning contests. Okay. Have you seen these men? Richard Baugh, Bruce Dansky, Jacob Miller on a camping trip overdue. Haven't been in contact. If you see them or know their whereabouts, please call 555-9932. Thank you. You're welcome.
Come in, Mr. Wake. Your phone's on the desk. The battery was dead. It's charged now.
Were you waiting there forever just so that the door would open and you could go, hello, Mr. Wake?
I'm picking it up. Have you started looking for my wife yet?
My men are already on it. Now, can you tell me what happened?
I'm not sure. I can't remember. We were arguing. I walked out of the cabin.
The cabin on Cauldron Lake? How did you end up at Stucky's gas station?
I wanted to tell her what happened last night, but I couldn't. She'd lock me up. Excuse me.
I have a caller.
Hello?
Alice, please help me.
Alice?
Stop talking, Alice? To Lamar. You'll do exactly what I say if you ever want to see your wife again.
Who is this?
Go to the back lot. There's a hole in the fence on the left. Look inside the junker. I left a little something there to convince you we're all on the same page here. After you ditch the cops, you're gonna meet me in Elderwood National Park. There's a spot called Lover's Peak. Midnight. Don't do nothing stupid, pal. We're watching you.
Who are you? I'm gonna do something really stupid
and
tell the sheriff.
I need some fresh air. Can I go out? In the back, maybe?
Of course, Mr. Wake. I understand. You can get there through the cells. Deputy Grant can show you the way.
I'm sorry. All of this, it's just a lot to take in.
Take your time, Mr. Wake. I understand. Can I ask you what the call was about, Mr. Wake?
It's personal.
Well, we are looking for your wife, and I'm going to need your cooperation if I'm going to help you.
I need a moment, after I get some fresh air.
Okay, you can find me here. We'll talk when you feel up to it.
Okay. Reed, what am I reading? Oh, these guys. Okay.
Mr. Wake, can I help you with anything?
I need to get some air. The sheriff said I could go out back.
Of course, Mr. Wake. You can get there through the cell corridor. Just don't mind Walter in there. He's one of our regulars.
I thought he quit drinking for good.
Oh, no such luck. He went on a bender and beat Dan pretty badly.
They don't understand. They won't listen to me. I need it to be bright in here.
I mean, I could, probably. Should I?
Thank you, man, thank you. Hey, you're all right. You're a good guy. Don't let anybody tell you different. You know, I shouldn't even be in here. The cops, they got it all wrong, see? Sure, I beat him up, but I wasn't drunk. I mean, I wasn't drunk at the time. I only got drunk afterward. Okay, listen.
Hey, that makes
listen,
sense.
Listen, you gotta listen carefully now. Here's the kicker. That wasn't Danny. No, sir. It only looked like him. You wanna know who it really was? I'll tell you who it really was. It was a goddamn space alien!
Oh,
it, sound like
it was a space alien.
A drunk would say, but believe me, I wasn't drunk then.
He wasn't drunk. You gotta believe him. All right, we'll see you later, man.
The early morning light hurt my eyes and made my head ache. The man on the phone had said, go through the fence on the left.
Go through the fence on the left. On my left? Focus. What am I focusing? Yeah, okay. I'm escaping the police, which just helped me. There we go. Can I... Ah, okay. I have a powerful kick. Wow. Manuscript page. Oh, is this the one that I missed? Okay. Wake at Lover's Peak.
His gun one last time, and the shadow vanished into the darkness it had come from. See? Nothing to it, Wake. The thought of Alice in his hands was revolting. We stood on the wooden platform of Lover's Peak, the waterfall on the mountain behind us, the lights of the radio mast blinking red in the heights above. I fought with the urge to take a swing, forced myself to speak. Let's cut the act now. Where's my wife?
I'm gonna pause real quick. Okay. I am back. Okay, let's,
Alice's driver's license had been placed on the front seat. The collar meant business.
Whoa. Oh no. Okay, I did not see that.
Barry?
Ow! Thank God! Where the hell have you been? I've been trying to reach you for a week, you and Alice. I've been worried sick. I flew out yesterday. I'm here in Bright Falls.
Barry, listen to me. I'm at the sheriff's station. Come and get me. I can't talk now.
I had to get the sheriff to let me go. I needed to get to Elderwood National Park to meet Alice's kidnappers.
I see. Okay, that makes sense. So Alice got kidnapped. And I'm going to save her. Oh, look, it's the ambulance. Where am I going? Coffee and
well,
a show.
Folks, it's been another long night, and it's about time for me to sign off for a while. God knows I need my beauty sleep. Just one more item before I go. It's been a busy night for the sheriff's department. We've had a few broken windows, even a report of shots fired on Main Street. Deputies Mulligan
shots
and
fired.
Had to deal with two intoxicated young men who were celebrating the completion of their Deer Fest float. Now, folks, we get this every year. I know it's exciting that the big day is almost here, but let's save it for the party and leave the gunplay for the shooting competition, huh? There's no point in getting all worked up yet.
That's a good idea. Exit the sheriff's station. Oh, that guy's gone.
The writer is
alive. Oh my God.
The world of his story from darkness. Shapes it from nothingness, the way a sculptor carves a statue from a block of granite. If I stop, the world I'm making dies. Darkness will reclaim it. It's a long, hard journey into the dark. Alice's life is at stake, but I can't think about that, or I'll lose it. The dread lingers at the edge of perception. I'll push on. Anything is possible here. I'll write the story. I'll save her.
Interesting.
Marvelous, Sarah. I just wanted to settle all Marvelous the damage Sarah. The Anderson brothers might have inadvertently caused on their recent...
Are you
okay,
feeling
well,
any better,
Mr. Wake?
Okay,
well, I didn't mean to interrupt that conversation.
I'd like to leave. Am I free to go?
Well, we still need to talk about...
Am I under arrest?
No, of course not. But I need to know where you'll be staying so I can get in touch with you.
I'd avoid the motel. The Majestic is known for its roaches. The cabins at Elderwood are pretty
Ew.
Nice, though.
That sounds perfect.
I'm Dr. Emil Hartman. I'd like to invite you to stay at Cauldron Lake Lodge.
Did you talk to my wife?
I had the pleasure of discussing your situation with her on several occasions.
Oh, that's the one on the book cover.
I invited her here. My clinic is a place where...
Oh, hey! Oh, my!
Yeah.
Take it easy.
I feel that wasn't deserved, but I liked it anyway.
Hey, nobody move! Get your hands off of my client!
Who are you?
I'm Barry Wheeler.
Barry?
His agent?
Yeah.
If you have business with Mr. Wake, you talk to me. You yokels won't know what hit you once I sick my lawyers on your asses.
No harm done, Sarah. I'm all right. I don't want to press charges. Mr. Wake, my offer still stands.
Get me out of here.
Yeah, Barry.
What the hell was that about, Al? We don't need a replay of that thing with the paparazzi. I thought they were gonna lock you up.
What thing with the paparazzi?
I told Barry everything. He thought I was certifiable, but when he heard about the manuscript, I had him. The fact that I'd written something, even if I couldn't remember it, was enough for him. He smelled money. And he believed that Alice had been kidnapped. Anything beyond that was another story. I had a midnight appointment with the kidnapper in a place called Lover's Peak, somewhere in Elderwood National Park. The plan was to rent a cabin.
I don't like it, Al. I don't like any of it. It's not good. In fact, it's the absolute opposite of good.
Mr.
Which
Wake.
Would be bad.
Barry, you
oh,
found him.
Oh, it's her, yes.
Oh, wow. I was just thinking about you, too.
Great.
I was just bringing Rusty some coffee. He's on the balcony, looking after Max. Poor thing. I really need to go.
Is Max.
Great to see you again, Mr. Wake. Later.
Who's
Barry a player?
What an airhead.
Jeez, Mr. takes a swing at everybody. This is not That's her me. Fault. She's a very nice girl and, more importantly, a fan. She even has a fan site dedicated to you. And
Perfect.
She was very helpful when I was looking for you. Seriously, Al, what you were saying in the car, just listen to yourself. What, you shot a guy and his body just disappeared? When was the last time you
Yeah.
What, are you high?
No.
Have you
I shot
drinking?
Carl Stuckey.
No! Look, Barry, I'm missing a week. And someone's got Alice.
Do
and
you
everything's
understand
just...
what it sounds like when you say stuff like that? Don't get me wrong. It's a good story. Could be a bestseller. But when you start confusing fiction with reality, you're buying yourself a ticket to the Funny Farm.
Wait here.
The Funny Farm. Where am I going? I forgot. Talk to Rusty. Who's Rusty? Let me in. Or don't. Rusty. Here we are.
Easy there, boy. I'm almost done.
Hey,
oh,
Rusty,
Max
right?
is a dog.
You rent cabins.
Oh, Mr. Wake. I'd shake your hand, but mine are kind of full here. Actually, I'm sorry about this. Would you mind grabbing the registration form from the desk? It's just across from Bucktooth Charlie.
Okay, sure. What happened?
Crazy poachers. Max here got his foot caught in a trap.
Poachers?
They're illegal
oh,
to
man.
Use here. Hell, you're not supposed to hunt within the park at all. But that doesn't stop some lowlifes. Well,
that
at least
sucks.
Max is gonna be okay. He got lucky. Max is still groggy
okay.
from the shot I gave him, and I'd rather not leave him alone just yet. The form's on the desk across from the mammoth skeleton.
Yeah, well, I'm doing it, but you keep talking me back.
Seriously,
I...
You can't just go and meet a kidnapper. Those situations always end up in disaster. You gotta talk to the cops. She's my wife, and it's my call. Can we talk about this later? No. This whole thing, it... Listen, you hit your head. I mean, geez, Al, come on. You gotta understand how crazy all this sounds. If you're trying to pull a joke on me, freak me out, it's working. Ha ha, let's have a laugh on Barry. Well, you had me going there real funny, Al. You can quit it now.
No, I'm... Look, I've been trying to say something this entire time. I sincerely hope the dog does not die. Because if the... I really... You know, dog deaths in video games are not my favorite thing in the world. So I really hope the dog does not die. Wasn't there something about a dog earlier? In one of the manuscript pages? I'm sure there was. There had to have been.
I stepped into the gas station's garage.
Right? No. Not this
I
one.
Heard them before
attacked
I saw
by
them
birds
swooping down from the sky.
I was never attacked by birds also, by the way. They just kind of were there. Okay.
I think this is
Here's
the form,
man.
And here are the keys. Okay, you're all set, Mr. Wake. Glad to have you staying here.
Thanks. Can you tell me how to get to Lover's Peak?
Oh, sure. It's at the end of the nature trail. Just follow the paths, you'll get to it eventually. It's an easy walk. Nice spot, too.
All right.
If you have any trouble
Sounds
finding
good.
It, just keep your eyes on the radio mast. It's right below that.
Okay.
Look,
out. Will do.
You're asking me to believe that you shot a dude who went poof into thin air, a guy
yeah.
who was bulletproof until you pointed a flashlight at him. You hear that from people who end up spending time in padded rooms, strapped to their beds, wearing white shirts with too long tangled up sleeves, and eating a healthy diet of pills. Al, you make cruel jokes about people who believe that kind of stuff. You're the skeptic. You gave me an hour-long lecture on homeopathy last month. What was it? If there's
no proof,
know
what that
it's
is.
Pure bullshit. Period.
Guess the laugh's on me, then.
Al, come on! I mean, okay. Okay, maybe something weird happened to you, okay?
Well, thanks for the heartfelt vote of confidence.
All I'm saying is you gotta throw me a bone here, bestseller. What would you think if it was me? There's no way you should be going out at midnight with a gun.
No one asked you to come here, Barry. Either work with me on this or go straight back to New York. Your choice.
Uh-huh. All right.
That's just crazy talk, Al. Al? Al? We should go to the sheriff or call the FBI.
Damn it, Barry. They'll kill her. This is not a goddamn debate, Barry.
That lamp did not make any noise
when
I threw it over.
He said to come alone.
Okay, okay then. I understand. You're my best friend, and I'm worried that you're not right in the head. Tell me what to do to help, and I'll do it.
You stay here, and if I'm not back by morning, call the cavalry.
The cavalry.
Achoo!
Bless you.
Achoo!
He sneezes into his hand.
Just be careful with the natives, Al. These yokels are dangerous. Everybody hates a tourist, or it'll be deliverance all over again.
Achoo!
Bless you.
Oh, this place is trying to kill me. I'll bet there's mold in here, spores, poison ivy, God knows what. This is so not worth a 15% commission.
Okay. Thermos. I knew there would be a thermos here somewhere. Batteries, also. I'll take it. Oh, I didn't mean to switch the lights. I don't know why it would let me do that. Let's keep going. We've got to head all the way up there, or up. Where did he say that it was? It's one of these mountains here.
I'll wait here, Al. I'll hold down the fort. I'll be with you in spirit every step of the way, Al. Walk through the door now.
Okay. Manuscript. Barry doubts
Barry
Wake's
never gotten
sanity
along with Alice, but he knew Alan loved her with an almost frightening intensity, and now something had happened to Alice, and here was Al armed with a gun and saying things people got put in padded cells for. It was as if his friend had experienced a massive psychotic episode and was now totally disconnected from reality. It scared the shit out of Barry.
Yeah, well, it would be too, I'll be honest. There's nothing else in here. Alright, let's go.
I knew I should have gone to the cops. This wasn't the smartest thing I'd ever done, but I was still angry with Barry for trying to talk me out of it. These people had called me right in the sheriff's station. The cops wouldn't scare them, and they had Alice.
What if they didn't have Alice? What if Alice is not there right now? What's this place? What happened? Are they gonna let me in here or no? There's a generator. Switch lights? Yep. Oh, it wasn't a generator, it was a radio.
Welcome back to the show, folks. As promised, our very own Dr. Nelson has just parked his rear end in the studio. Doc, what's your Deerfest plan like?
My plan? You make it sound a lot more organized than I ever seem to manage.
No plan, really.
Just taking the atmosphere. I'm getting a little too rickety to do much more than that, you know.
Oh, tell me about it. No sack race for us older gentlemen, huh?
Yes, exactly, Pat. But I'm going to check out the parade, of course. And I'll be one of the pie contest judges, too.
Well, that takes a different kind of constitution.
Oh, yeah, it's my kind of exercise.
Now, Doc, seriously, you're in pretty good shape, though. You're the outdoors type. I know for a fact you're an avid fisherman.
That's right. Matter of fact, just caught a heck of a largemouth bass early this morning.
But you're not taking part in the fishing contest?
No, not this year. See, Pat, I'm just not that competitive anymore. Now I just like to take my time and enjoy the peace of it. It's no fun if I need to worry about what I'm catching, you know?
Considering your track record, the participants are probably pretty happy you feel that way.
Well, Pat, that's kind of you to say.
Yeah, it is pretty kind of him to say, I suppose. Let's go this way. Towards the tire swing. I love a good tire swing. I mean, it did start swinging on its own, but... Whoa. Hey, whoa. What's going on? I was just swinging this tire around. You don't have to do that to me. Drop hazard. Well, I guess I'm gonna fall off. Am I going down or up? I don't suppose I'm going down, but I'll go this way just for the cabin. Lover's Peak, that way. Oh, okay, it is this way. Drop hazard. Moonshine Cave, Elderwood Nature Trail. Okay. Let's head in this cabin. Hey. More on the TV. I don't know if I want to watch this, considering what happened last time.
Crime and Punishment.
Yeah, no, I don't want to watch this show.
The Cancer and Cure.
I'm alright, thanks, though. Let's see. Is there anything else in here? Punish,
especially in Night Springs. Tonight's episode.
Oh.
The Man in the Mirror.
I didn't know that there was blood on the floor. That's interesting.
He's inside, Agent.
Yeah, I'm alright. I'm good. Ooh, look at the moon. Phone, yes please. I guess I don't need it. Walking. Driving. Are these guys coming to... No, okay. I didn't know if they were coming this way or going away. Manuscript.
The air in the visitor center was heavy with an awful smell, as if some rotten, drowned thing had crawled up from its grave. Rusty kept coughing blood. My eyes were drawn to the twisted shape of his broken leg. The attack had been vicious. Max whined in his cage. Rusty's eyes were wild with fear and terror. He gasped. Mr. Wake, it happened just the way it was on that page.
Oh no. At least Max is in his cage. As long as Max doesn't die, I'm all for everything that's going on. Let's keep going. Fallen rock zone. Rocks are gonna fall on me and I'm gonna die. Whoa. Oh.
The vision left me weak. This was no head injury.
Okay, I don't know what's going on.
Rusty, hang on!
Oh,
I'm coming!
Please, help me!
Ooh, what? Where? I'm going.
Help me.
I'm here, man.
Help
I'm here to save you.
Help me.
Where are you?
Can you hear me? Anyone? Please help!
I don't know where
help
you're
me.
At, dude.
Hello?
Oh, are
back
we
here.
Hello?
I'm back here.
We're back in the cabin.
Please help me.
Oh my god.
Mr. Wake?
I just read it on the manuscript, but I'm still surprised.
Oh hell. It happened.
What happened?
Just the way it was on that page. I found came true.
Max.
It knew. So dark. It'll come back for me. You must the lights. In the office. I have the key.
Okay, Rusty. Hang on. I'll be right back.
I'll be right back. Don't worry about
Whatever
it, man.
Did this couldn't be far. Rusty had found a page from the manuscript. It would help me understand what had happened.
Oh no. This is not a good thing. What about this one? Where did he say the thing was? What happened here? Is it this?
Shh,
oh, right.
Good boy.
Can I open this? No. Okay. Where did he say the thing was? Sir? Oh, God. Is it a different building? Maybe.
The only way to make sure that Rusty was safe was to get the power running and the lights back on.
Right. So I need a way to turn on the power. Oh, manuscript. Rusty attacked by the dark presence. All right.
Was sturdy. But the impact turned the front of the building into splinters. Rusty was thrown across the lobby like a rag doll and hit the far wall hard. It didn't hurt until he tried to move and saw his leg bend the wrong way, felt the broken rib stabbing him on the inside. Rusty howled in pain and fear, suddenly afraid to die alone.
Yeah, that doesn't tell me what did it to him, though. Is the power in here? Yeah, okay, because it says unlock. Manuscript page. Does this tell me what happened? Wake reaches a safe haven of light.
At the last
oh, okay,
instant,
cool.
I changed direction and threw myself down. The axe splintered the trunk of a tree. I stumbled into the pool of bright light. My lungs burned. I was too exhausted to move. I tensed as I waited for the killing blow, but it never came. I raised my head. Nothing moved in the darkness beyond. For the moment, bathed in the cold light, I was safe.
So I fight someone with an axe? Lights. I need the lights on. That's what I'm doing in here. Batteries, revolver, yes, please. Back here.
That was too late. Someone had destroyed the circuit breaker. There was no way to get the lights back on.
Oh, no.
Rusty!
Oh my god. Let's go. Let's go. Oh, the door's this way. I'm too late.
The ground was covered with oily patches that looked like liquid darkness.
Oh no. Hunters need hunting licenses. Who are you guys? Are you guys people I know? I can shine away the black splotches on the ground. Should I do that? Why would I need to do that? Does it waste my battery? No, I'm still at 11. Huh. Interesting. Well, I need to save Rusty, but he's already dead. They better not have... Alright. They better not have killed this dog. If they killed the dog, I don't know. I may have to stop for... I may have to stop for today.
Something had torn a mammoth-sized hole in the wall.
He's gone. Okay, well, the dog's gone, but he's not explicitly dead,
please,
so...
You know, I'll keep playing. Animals.
Huh?
Fishing! Is only permitted at 4,000 visitors who purchase a park fishing license. Obey! The park ranger's instructions. At all times.
Rusty? Rusty, no!
Never!
Oh, Rusty.
Two bears and wolves! Never approach any other.
Should I have shot him during that moment?
Pets must be leashed. Never leave your pet unattended.
Oh.
It is against the law to remove any natural objects or historical artifacts from the park grounds. This includes even rocks you may.
Okay, I got him. Under a thin layer of skin. Oh, there's more. We're good. Okay. The dog better not come after me then. Okay. Let's keep going. That is not good. Alright, so we learned something from this encounter. We learned something. If one of the shadow guys, like, reaches you and kills you, then you get taken over by the darkness, and then you become the darkness. Right. That's what happened to Rusty, to Ricky. Rusty. I got a phone call.
What the hell was that? I saw it from the window. I saw something.
Forget about it, Barry. It's just me going crazy.
Oh, jeez. Oh, jeez. You're not crazy. I wish you were crazy, but you're not crazy. Ow, be careful.
Stay in the cabin. Don't open the door for anyone. I mean it.
Oh. Manuscript. Rusty's final thoughts? Oh no!
In that last instant of consciousness, Rusty thought about Rose. He was older than she was. Rose was barely out of her teens. But she made him feel young and forget what a train wreck his long dead marriage had been. He still wore the ring. He'd been waiting for her to tell him to take it off. Now she never would.
Man. That's not the best. Did I go over there? Batteries, revolver ammo. Let's go down. Should I go up? Maybe. For your safety, stay on designated hiking trail. Do not feed wildlife.
Lover's Peak was at the far end of the nature trail.
Of course it was. Oh, well, that's broken. Do not feed wildlife. Oh, okay. That's the same thing. Phone. Porta potty. I'm in. Oh no. Yeah, just try. Just try. Oh my god, he tried. I thought there was only the two. There was a third. Lover's Peak is a mountain, right? How am I supposed to scale a mountain? Oop, where am I going? Can't tell. I thought for sure there was another path over here. We're in another darkness storm, so this is not gonna be it. Do I go up or do I go down? I assume that I'm going up. Is this right? Is this a path? No, I'll go down. Aha, I saw you. Are you gonna die? Whoa. That's fine. The great old one. Felled by lightning in 1937. Oh! This exceptionally tall Rocky Mountain Douglas fir, which I'm not gonna read the scientific name of that because I definitely can't. Was over 200 years old. According to local legends, it stretched beyond the stars. After it fell, it was measured to be 66 meters tall, which is nearly a record length. Interesting. Hiking trail. Okay, so it senses the hiking trail. Oh no. There's three. There's another one. Keep it going. Lover's Peak. Oh, behind me. I didn't see how many there were. only have 3 bullets left? Not good. I don't need this, but I might as well have it. There we go. Checkpoint, thank goodness. And, yep, revolver ammo, thank goodness also. This phone is broken, but I don't need a phone anyway. Okay. Let's continue. Manuscript, I didn't even see it. Here we are. Wake sees the torch symbol.
I turn the corner, afraid of what the flashlight's beam might reveal. Suddenly, a roughly painted symbol of a torch glowed in the light. Behind it, hidden by a rock, sat a battered metal trunk. It was here for a reason. Packed with supplies, batteries, flares, ammo. Things you need to make it through the darkness of the night. Something left behind by someone who knew what I knew, and more.
Right, okay. I've seen a torch symbol before. I've been streaming for 138 minutes. Can you believe it? That may be a record. I'm not entirely sure, but I think it's a record. For me. Okay. Let's keep it going. Bear alert. That's a something. Stained with blood. White. Looks like maybe a white shirt. Oh. There's 2. 3. There's 3. There's 4. There's 2 men. Let me get out of here. Float like a butterfly? I don't know why I got that achievement. I'll have to look later. Oh my god. Ow. Are these guys... Oh my lord. Ow. Let's get out of here. I'm running. There was a light somewhere back here, was there not? Ah! Okay. I died. Yeah, let me try it one more time. Do I have a flare gun? No, I just have my regular gun. Oh, I saw him, but I wasted a bit of my flashlight. I tried again. Okay, so there's 4 of them. Okay. He's good. Oh, okay, got him. I didn't even mean to. Ah! You still... Okay. I'm dead again. So, I don't know how that guy got behind me and also didn't attack me, you know? Okay, let's go. Come on, man. You're wasting my time and yours by being alive. Got him. Stop. Dude, I can't move. There's 3 behind me. Oh my god. Oh my lord. Oh my lord. Let's go. Oh, that was a good dodge. Let's keep going. Let's keep that going. Okay. Okay. I cannot run, apparently. So maybe I'll just stand back a little bit so that I'm not, like... So that I'm not immediately bombarded, right? If I run early, I should be able to get a little bit further before I have to be ready for him. Okay, got him. Okay, there were actually five of them. If I'm in the light, they can't hurt me, right? Will they still come over here? Don't worry, I've got all the time in the world. Okay, I did it, I think. I'm pretty sure we're done here. I do have 4 bullets left. Lover's Peak. That's Lover's Peak. How am I supposed to get up there? Am I supposed to go this way? For your safe. For your safe? D. Oh, okay. Well, I just missed the ginormous hole in the wall. We're fine. Through tree. Okay. I'm going through the tree. There's the hiking trail. Dogs must be leashed. That's too bad. I feel like I really want to shoot that, but I'm not gonna. This tree, the tree this ring was cut from, started growing in 1846, the year the Oregon Treaty was signed. Other notable events marked on the rings: 1853, the Washington Territory was farmed. 1878, the founding of Bright Falls Mine and Company in the town itself. 1889, Washington was granted statehood. 1929, tree damaged in a forest fire. 1970, the Bright Falls Mine & Co. closes its doors after volcanic eruption below Cauldron Lake. 1980, Mount St. Helen erupts. 1987, which is the Bite of 87 from Five Nights at Freddy's, is a tree felled by the storm. Everything scary happens in the 80s, I've learned this. Can I move this? I can. Great. Okay. Visitor center, cafe, souvenir shop. I'll go to the cafe. What is this? Well, that's where I came from, so it's... Let's jump over the fence. That makes sense. Okay, that's just the hiking sign. Oh, ski lift! It all makes sense how I'm gonna get up to the mountain now. It makes perfect sense. B to use. Yeah, come on down here. I mean, up here. You're going down. There we go. Let me on. Please keep doors closed. What if I don't? Oh. Oh no. Everything is fine. Not. Oh. Oh my lord. Not a good thing. Are we good? We're good. Oh no, there's shadow people. And I don't have my light. Oh no. Whoa. Flare gun. Who flared for me?
Come on, we gotta get
Who
moving.
Are you?
More of them coming.
Hey, thanks, man.
That flashlight's
Let's
kid
go.
Stuff. The flares will keep the bastards away.
They both will. Don't insult my flashlight. I've been using it this whole time.
You can see them too?
Hell, of course I see them. Come on, we gotta move.
Why?
Because that's the way the story goes.
Yeah, but...
Let's move!
I lost my gun back there.
Oh, I've got a gun. Just keep that light steady on him.
It took a moment, but then I recognized him. He'd been on the ferry when I first arrived here with Alice. He knew my name.
Oh!
We were headed in the direction of Lover's Peak. There was no way this was a coincidence. He was the kidnapper.
Come on, Wake! You better keep up!
He was the kidnapper? What do I do? Did I not? Was I not supposed to put that down? Like, what? I did. Ow! Oh, there's one behind us, man. Sir. Oh. Thanks, man. You really saved me. I don't have enough health for this kind of stuff. Bullseye. Oh, I didn't even see him. There you go. I don't even have my gun.
Monster! Lover's Peak.
Oh my lord.
These stairs, Wake. Use the flares from the emergency box to hold them off while I get these boards off.
Give me the gun.
Yeah, no can do, Wake.
Are you kidding? Give me the gun!
No time for back talk. Hold them off, damn it.
I'll hold them off. Don't even worry about it. RB to use a flare.
A little longer. Scare him off.
I'm scaring him. What are you gonna do about this?
Get some light on those
I'm doing him. I got him. Don't even worry about it. Okay, I believe you. I'm moving. Let's go.
Stop fighting me!
Get the light.
Oh, you feeling better now, Wake? All cozy and safe.
Yes, I am.
Better get ready. They'll be on us soon.
This guy's the kidnapper? I don't know.
This is it, Wake. The last stand. There's more players here. Get ready. We fight them as long as they keep coming.
Give me the goddamn gun! They're coming!
That's not how this goes. Get with the program, Wake.
How dare you?
Hear that? It's
all right. Get out of here.
Thank you.
Come and get some, huh? I dare you, dude. Oh, watch out. Ah, help me out, man.
It's a piece of cake, Wake.
Coffee thermos. Coffee thermos. I got a coffee thermos. Watch out behind you, man. I don't have any more flares. Okay, there's no more.
Where's my wife?
I knew you were gonna say that. I read it all before. You're a hell of a writer. Congratulations. You're gonna bring about something glorious and terrible once we get you some proper editorial control.
What the hell are you talking about? Where's Alice?
I want the entire manuscript, or she's gonna suffer bad.
You touch her off.
Oh. Yeah, oh no. I was gonna say, you touch her and I'll punch you in the face, and then I punched him in the face anyway. I have the gun.
You're gonna give me the manuscript or you'll be sorry.
No! Come back here! I swear I'll kill you if you hurt Alice! Do you hear me? Come back here!
Yeah. Alice's fear of the dark.
On more than one occasion, Alice had tried to explain to me how it felt to be afraid of the dark. To her, darkness wasn't simply the absence of light, but something more tangible than that. It was something you could touch and feel. Worse than that, it was something with a mind of its own, something malicious and malign. For her, things changed when they were wrapped in darkness. They turned into something else, something foreign, and nothing was safe or innocent anymore. I'd never really understood what she meant until now.
All right.
He had Alice, and he wanted the manuscript because he thought it held some magical power. But I had no manuscript to give him. I had to get back to Barry and figure out my next move.
Well, then let's get back to Barry. Make it through the woods. Simple enough. I did regain my gun and I did see that guy. Come out here. Or don't. What is this?
What the hell?
Oh my god.
Rusty,
I've got a bear trap.
Hell.
Hey, that's no fair. Okay, don't step on traps. Got it. If there's a shiny thing on the ground, do not step. Yeah, all these, just don't. Just not the best, not a good idea. Oh, okay. Whoa, he missed. Come on, come on, come on. It's basically a free hit for them. And that's no good, because I'm losing health. Let's go. Okay. I keep trying to press A instead of B for picking up stuff, because I'm... A is usually picking up everything in games. Am I regaining my health? I think I am. Yeah, I am. Checkpoint. Hey. 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 Came out from the bushes. I saw you this time.
What the?
I don't know what that is. I'm busy, man. Battery. Barrels. I need to get through the woods. I do have everything. I do have a lot of health. I have 7 batteries, 34 bullets. Missed. Idiot. Where are you at? Where are you at? Oh, did you fall down? Ow. Oh, God. Oh, I didn't notice. Ow. Okay. Oh, I didn't know I could go down here. How do I get back up, though? I just have to use the... There's no lights out here. Ow. Stop that. Darn it, man. Okay. Where am I going? Oh, I just got up here. I thought you were gone. I'm lost. pausing for 1 second. All right, let's continue. That took a lot. Ow. Stop. I don't know how you missed. Where am I in the game? Manuscript page.
The night Wake hears a chainsaw. Desperate situation after another. I was exhausted, and my body felt as though it had been chewed up and spat out. The flashlight was heavy in my hand, and each pull of the trigger sent a painful shock up my arm. But I was finally out of the woods, and things were looking up. That's when I heard the chainsaw.
Oh no. I love a good chainsaw. Hunting rifle, yes, please. Okay. That's when I heard the chainsaw. I'm excited to see the chainsaw. I am not excited to face the chainsaw. Oh, look at that. There's a generator. Checkpoint. All right.
I had heard the plane fall. It made no sense. It was clear that it had just fallen here. It was very old and obviously hadn't flown in decades. Looking at it sent a shiver through my spine.
Very interesting. I thought that was where the plane was. No, it's over. Where is it? Where's the plane? There it is. Okay. So that's what that big noise was. That was the plane falling to the ground. That makes sense. Oh, it's goo on the plane. It's guck. In? Is it in the plane? Well, I don't want this to fall. Yeah, okay, that's what I thought. Ah! Luckily, I ran out of there. Oh my lord. Oh, there we go. What's the breathing? Flares. Okay, sounds good. Means there's gonna be a lot of them eventually. Is the breathing my breathing? Okay. Let's go this way. Under here? Maybe. Flare, yeah. This is the place where it's gonna be a horde, I assume. Yep. Okay, let's flare them. Try your luck. I didn't mean to drop both of those. Both of those I did not mean to drop. Oh, I forgot. I have a hunting rifle on me. I should save that, most likely. Hey, guy, stop that. Oh, okay. I already used up all my flares, because I didn't mean to drop the first two. Well, I didn't mean to drop the first one, and I was going to make it seem like I did it on purpose. And then I dropped the second one, and I couldn't. Okay. Get back. Oh, yeah. I'm gonna reload. Got him. Health's already. I'm taking rifle ammo. Yeah. Do I have a place to go? Am I going this way? Let's see. Into the darkness smoke. No, this is the river. I can't go across the river. Past this barrel is the way that I came, so maybe I can go this way. Nope. Okay. Maybe I can go... this way. Yeah, this seems right. We lost the sound of the storm for this for a second. Okay, I'm confused on where to go. That's the light. Should I go towards this light? I'm a bit tired. I don't know how I'm supposed to get up there. Aha! Maybe? No, okay. That's definitely doer. Well, I fought this way. Oh, how did I not see that? How did I not? Big bright light right there. Coffee thermos. I don't know how I'm gonna get over there, but... oh, I know how I'm gonna get over there. I'm gonna go over here. Oh my lord, I pressed the wrong button to dodge. Whoa, okay. Look at that. I thought I dodged. Reach the top of the mill. Can I climb? I can climb. Okay. What's going on here? Scared me a little bit. Is this how I'm gonna get in? Yep. Alright. Let me get the gunk out of this place. Okay. Pick up revolver ammo. Oh, hey, wait a minute. Who was that? And where? That's not fair. I don't know where you are. If I step on the gunk, does something happen? I assume that's why I can get rid of it. Manuscript? Where? There. Oh my god, I missed a lot of pages. Okay. Whoops. I didn't mean to do that.
The logging site was a mess. The modular office had been pushed off the cliff. Deputy Thornton climbed up from the wreckage excited, breathing hard from the exertion. Nobody there. It's weird. Don't you think that's weird? Bored, Mulligan let out a mighty snort. Hell, it's always weird, Thornton. Just a question of sorting out what kind of weird it is this time around.
Interesting. Well, I got hit by an axe the last time I entered this room, so I've got to be on my guard. Kick? What am I kicking? Oh, that makes sense. Hey, let me up there. That flares, that makes sense. It looked like a fiery, like, metal L. Ah, coffee. Ladder. Some of that gunk. It's a bit of a fixer-upper. I don't like the creek.
Beware of Widowmakers.
Oh. I'm aware. The darkness wears her face. I assume her is that veil lady from the very beginning. Hunting rifle. I heard a noise. Should to jump over this? Can I jump over this fence? No, it's a barrel. Am I parkouring? Is this what's going on? Oh, okay. Let me try it again. Whoa! Ladies and gentlemen, I am not usually good at parkour. Okay, well, I don't know where I go from here. Do I gotta make it through the woods? Oh, okay. I thought it was still make it to the top of the well, but apparently it was not. Come on. I ran too fast and I got off the board before I could, off the box before I could jump. Come on. I'm this close. There we go. Alright. Now, I go there and then. Oof, where do I go? Am I even supposed to be parkouring right now? I don't think I am. There's the river. I keep thinking that's a coffee thermos, but it is clearly not. There we go. I figured it all out. Come on. Okay. Lithium batteries, revolver ammo. My item limit is reached. Okay. We did this before. Campgrounds. Is that where I'm supposed to be going? Flare. Are we good? Are we good? Is my audio fine? Okay, my audio is fine. I am streaming from my Xbox right now, and my Xbox removed me from the party, and I have party chat on, so my voice may have been cut out for a second there, but we're good now, so let's keep it going. After I complete this chapter, I think I'm gonna stop streaming Alan Wake, and I don't know, maybe I'll stream something else, or maybe I won't stream at all. Oh, chainsaw. That's what I'm talking about. I love a good chainsaw. I killed Chainsaw Guy already. That's too bad. I thought he would stay for longer. Okay, let's go. Campgrounds. Checkpoint, all right.
Barry?
Ow! The porch is covered with birds. They've got all Hitchcock on me.
Stay out of sight. I'm on my way. Don't open the door.
What, am I crazy?
Stay hidden. I'll be there soon. Just make sure you keep the lights on.
I'm gonna kill those birds.
I still had to reach Barry at the cabin, but at least I was out of the woods.
Thank goodness. Item limit reached.
I'd have to get the car from the locked garage. It would get me back to Barry faster, and the headlights were a welcome bonus.
Okay, well, I need, what, keys to unlock it? Closed for renovation. Manuscript in the bathroom. Okay. Nightingale fires at Wake.
The FBI agent's command froze me in place. I considered surrender. It was all falling apart anyway. I could give in, let someone else deal with it. But it felt all wrong. Call it instinct, his posture, the way he held the gun. He was no friend. Shots ringing in my ears, I leaped for the hole in the fence and stumbled into the darkness beyond.
Oh. Nightingale, who? Stop that, please. Is it TV? Nothing on the TV? I found the garage keys, all right.
A story is not a machine that does what you tell it. A story is a beast with a life of its own. You can create it, shape it, but as the story grows, it starts wanting things of its own. Change one thing and you set off a chain reaction of events that spreads through the whole thing. The characters have to be true to themselves. The events need to follow a logic that fits the story. A single flaw and the magic is gone. The story dies. Alice dies.
So what I'm gathering is that maybe I had, so in the week that, I was gone, I had to write the story or else Alice would die or something. So like somebody was holding Alice captive until I wrote the story, maybe? I don't know. Hypothesis. And if anybody would be holding me captive to write the story, it'd be my manager who wants me to write a story. You know what I mean? So I don't know. I can drive. I can actually drive in this game. This is crazy. Oh yeah, come at me. I'm gonna hit you with my car. Yeah, boost the lights. I see. Change vehicle controls. I don't want to. Let's go. Turn to Barry. Okay. How do I boost the lights? I forgot. I already forgot. There we go. I'll just speed through. Everything's fine. Oh my god, I did not mean to get out of the car, man. Let me back in. Why am I out? Why am I out of the car? Let me in. Yeah, okay. That was deserved. That was deserved. Let's drive. So how do I get out of the car? Because apparently I can. Accelerate. Steering. Brake. Reverse. A to boost the lights. Jump in. That was terrible. Where? Side? To the side? Yeah. Out of my way, man. Am I supposed to go off the road? Okay. Well, I'm trying to turn around. There we go. Is this where I'm supposed to be? I assume, maybe. Ah! Yeah, okay. This is the place where this guy got demolished. Right. Okay, well you can't tell me when he's already so close to me that he's gonna axe me twice. Where's the cabin? Is this the cabin? No, because there's no upper floor. We were on the upper floor. Ah! Why did you not tell me? Let's get in the car. What happens if I... Come on, there's... an obvious gap there. How am I supposed to get out of here? There we go. Okay, I assume maybe I have to get out of the car up the trail. Whoops. Stop. Stop. That's 4 hits from 2 people. Let me in the car, man. Okay. Don't get out. Ever. If you get out of the car at any point, you will die. Can take like off road. I'll do that. Let's go. Okay, that was once again not good. Right, so we're here. But now we're over here, because this is where the road goes. But I can't, because the cars are blocking it. So should I get out? Checkpoint reached. Okay, I assume that I should have done that. Bright Falls light and what?
The flare gun was probably the best weapon I could imagine against the dark things I was facing.
I got him. This is the cabin. Right? So. Ow! Where? Where from? I thought the flare gun not only, like, I thought the flare gun also killed them. I suppose it does not. Ah, thank goodness. Okay. There's the tire swing. I'm getting a call.
You son of a bitch!
What?
Where's my wife?
Enough horseplay, Wake. You deliver the manuscript, and you can have your woman back. Simple as that.
I don't... Listen. Listen. I'm gonna need time to finish it. I still need to write the ending. I need... a week.
It's not done?
I need a week.
2 days! The old Bright Falls coal mine is nearby. You can find it easy, city boy. The main building, there at noon. You bring the manuscript, you'll get your wife. Not. Well, get me.
Yes, yes, I get you.
Thank goodness. Now, where's Big Barry? There's the cabin. The birds. Oh. I see what he means.
Barry had talked about birds over the phone.
The darkness controls the Taken. So if I flare gun the birds, is what you're saying?
Al! Al, I am so glad you're here. A couple of them got in here before I blocked the chimney. This isn't normal. These birds are weird.
Yeah, they are. Let me in, man. What do you say? Ah! Hey, don't do that. Oh, I see.
Look at the pigeons back home or bad. Al, make them go away, please.
What? Oh my lord. Whoops. Wasted. Ah! Come at me. I've got a flare. Come at me. Ah, don't come at me. I don't have a flare. How am I supposed to kill all of these birds? Stop. How many of these birds are I supposed to take off? I saw flare gun ammo. Okay. We've got to be close to the end of the chapter, right? This door or the front one? The front one.
Hey, Al. I'm sorry for thinking you were having a psychotic episode, man.
It's all right.
I sent Barry to the town to ask around about a man fitting the kidnapper's description. He'd go through the archives of the local paper. Perhaps he could learn something. Anything about the island and the cabin that had disappeared. The man wanted a manuscript. I had to try to write him one to get Alice back.
Right. Write it good so that, like, good things happen. And then they can all, like, actually happen, you know?
For me, the supernatural had always been nothing but a metaphor for the human psyche, a tool to use in writing fiction. Now, it was happening for real, and I couldn't put a single word on paper.
Oh, man. Here's Barry.
Wheeler speaking.
This is Rose.
Rose?
I found Mr. Wake's pages.
Oh, you sweet, brilliant girl.
Could you and Mr. Wake come get them? I live in the trailer park outside the town.
We'll be there in less than an hour.
I know.
See you soon.
Have a great day. Hope you come back soon. Welcome to the Old Deer Diner.
Good girl.
Oh, no. All right. I assume that's the end of the chapter.
Come here.
Yeah. Pretty please. Alan Wake.
Can you tell me where I am? You. Won't you say something?
End of episode 2.
I need to get my.
All right. That was good. I had a really fun time with that. That was Alan Wake episodes 1 and 2. Very interesting. Gameplay is a little repetitive, but I think it's a fun time. I am gonna stop for now.
Previously on Alan.
I'll click skip, but. Yeah, so that I can get the achievement. But I think that is gonna be it for me. Thank you all for tuning in. I will probably come back to Alan Wake episodes 3 through whatever. Yeah, that I'm Pear, and thank you very much. We'll see y'all later.